So today we will learn about range, this how to use this these range and selection methods. I just name it.
Did you send the book, sir? You told that you will send some
no, I still have something not. Actually, it is my in my second computer. I will need to download that, or we can find it here. What its name? VBA tutorial PDF. Which one it is? It was like there are a lot of books actually. But what is that which I use? It is Excel Power Programming with VBA. One second. You can find on internet also Excel Power Programming with VBA PDF. This is for 11 MB here. This book I usually use. So if you have torrent, you can download from here also.
Yeah, yeah, I have the torrent here.
So Excel Power Programming with VBA.
Okay.
Okay, otherwise I will send you that.
No, 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 I can download it. It's, this is the case, okay.
Okay.
Is a good book?
Yes, yes, it is the basic book of programming.
Okay.
Okay. So in range keyword, we start with range keyword. For every selection, we need this range keyword. First, see if I want to select this A1 cell, I just put it in range keyword. So when I play the macro, you can see the selection, it is A1. Then we have another way, like cells, we can use cells keyword also. Here we don't need to give the address like A1, B2, just like that. We need to identify that fourth row, row number and column, second column number. When I play this, you will find this.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Hello. When you play this macro, it will go to fourth row and second column number. One second, sir. Hello.
Hello.
Now you can hear me, sir.
I'm not able to hear you, sir.
Still. Hello. Hello. What happened? My voice is not clear. Hello. 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 Check your
hello.
Hello. Check your connection.
I'm not able to hear you, sir. Can I restart my PC? Can I restart the this thing? The
yes.
What you called? Go to meeting.
Yes, yes. we can use cell keyword for using as range. In cell keyword you will find that you have two entries here. First is row number, second is column number. You don't need to give it address like A1, B2, B4. You can give in numbers, row number and column number. When you play this macro, you will find that this fourth row and second column is selected here. Okay. Now, we also use this as a reference active cell. If I just use active cell dot value equal to any value I put here, so you can see when I play this macro, it will change the value of active cell. Okay. Now, if I need to select a whole range, such as range, I can give by this way also, A1 colon epsilon, like whole range. I'm selecting here, so I'll find when I play this macro, this whole thing is selected here. Then sometimes we use partial selection. Like I want to select this this address, then we this address with the help of this control key. So this type of selection can be made through range keyword. In brackets you can give A1, in commas you can give different type of values, B3. So you will see when I play this macro, so you will find three selections are there. Okay. Now we use control A. Sometimes we use control A. Like when we press control A, earlier in 2003 version, it is used to select whole sheet. For your whole worksheet will be selected by a control A, but in Excel 2007 and upper version, you will find when you press control A, it selects the current region, current data region. If you type some values here, so when you press control A, it will take the non-breakable reference here, which has not been broken, that data range. So that is called current region. So if you want to choose the current region, you can give this range keyword. A1 is the first reference and the current region you can find here. Select. So current region is selected. Where it is current region in our normal Excel, when you select anything, you go to Home tab, Find and Select, and go to Special. Here you will find current region. Okay. The same thing. Then we need to select the value like this one. Select this data range. So what I will use here, because in when we use macro programming, we need to select data and then we do all the things. So first thing first, I need to select this data range. So what I do for selection, either I can select this ASL and then press Control Shift and press down key and then right key for the selection. So I need, when I need to select A1 to A11, I need to press Control Shift and then press down. In VBA mode, what it's happened here,
I can freely select this K1. Then I will press end key from my keyboard, where it is end, and when I press end key, so I can see here there is end mode. Okay, then I press down key. What happens? It frequently moves to the end of the data, such as when you press end key again and press the right key, it will move to end of the data. So this thing we do through
end key with right key. Okay, both we need to press, or just first activate the mode of end key?
Yes, you need to activate the mode of end by pressing end key, then you can release it and use that down key arrow, your arrow keys actually. So I need to select, because there can be a lot of data, I don't know whether it is on A11 or A17 or A14. So I need to understand that, I need to find the last cell of data. So what I will do, I will go to the maximum extent of the cell, then I will press end mode and then press up. So I will find the ending point of this data. Then when again I press end and with shift, when I press up key, so I find the whole data. So how to do this through range? In range, we go down, so such as we type A65000, first reference. Then we press dot end. This is end mode. In end mode, in brackets, you can give the directions to Excel down, Excel left, Excel right, Excel up. So where I want to go? Up, in up direction. So I will use Excel up. Okay. Then I press select. Okay. So when I run this macro, I will find it will go in the last data range. Then from here, if I want to go and I have chosen data from here, now I want to go with this selection, so I can use range keyword, and we can use selection keyword also in there. Selection refer to a selection. Okay, selection. Then selection dot end Excel up dot select. So when I use this function, then it selects the whole range. It gone down, then come up here with shift. It was like this one. So first reference it got from selection, which was its reference of the upper column. So that reference is here. Then with selection it has done this thing. So it has chosen like this range. And we can also do the same thing, selection dot end Excel right dot select. There is all there is always error in this type of selection. Just forget about that. So we can select a range here. Then what we supposed to do? Now I want to take the value of this cell, second cell or third cell. So through offset we can move down here. So how to use offset? Use this selection keyword. Then I want from offset dot offset. Offset is a keyword you can directly use by after range also and after end XLup also. So it asks for row offset, which I give here as 0, and I type it 2. 2 means when it comes to this point, then this is the column point and this is the row point 0. Okay. Then the column point I have given 3. So 0 column it is here, then 1, 2, 3. This value it will return. Okay. So dot value keyword I can use, and in MSG box I am returning this value. Let's play. So this value you can find here, 62, 2, 0, 1, 2. Let us not use this selection, this keyword already. So it moved on 16. Now this is all about a range, how to use a range and selection. Then what we need to do, when we are wrapping these ranges, that means it will be worked only on active sheet. If we want to access the sheet 2 or any specific sheet, we need to specify the sheet name also. So suppose I want to put the value in sheet 2, so I can refer, yesterday I told you some methods of referring sheets. By that method we can use sheet 2 range, this one, value, any value I have settled down here. I want to type this value in sheet 2. I just play this one. So I will find in sheet 2. There is the value. So you understand how to group with sheets. Now if you have different workbooks, such as here I have book 1 and book 2. Here I want to work in book 2. Then I need to specify here workbook, and I need to give the book name, book file name, name. Okay, then I play this, but I got an error because without activating that workbook I can't work. So this workbook need to be activated. First we need activation of that. You can transfer the value without activation. You can pick the values without activation but not transfer. Object doesn't support this property or method. Why? There is a problem there. There is sheet 2. Let's activate that now. Sheet 2 dot range A1 value. Okay, I need to activate the sheet also. No. Sheets. Second index. Maybe some problem is there. Now this is working fine. If there can be any problem, which can be tackled by any of the following option. Sometimes you will find that here I am using workbook. In one Excel application, you will find there are two workbook, two files. Sometimes what happens, you have a different Excel application and another workbook open in that. So what happened there, your workbook function will not accessible there, because you can see there is a there are application, in single application there are two workbook. If it is open in this mode, then it will be accessible by workbook. But if it is not like that, it will give you the error. So you can also use window keyword, windows, it will do the same thing. Okay, so now let us create a form here, a short form for transferring data to understand these functions. So I just create a form here, such as name. If I create a form, marks. Then I need to give here a button. Button. Okay, so I need to code here the transfer file. Give the name as form. And the data will be managed in data sheet, such as date, time, and name, roll number, marks, and serial number. This sheet we will maintain the database. So I just firstly create a macro here for that. Subject data PR transfer. In this, what we need to do, I need to specify the address. It is C2, C4 and C6 of these. For these input boxes which are created through Excel. Now what I will do, on the click of the button we need to put the value there. Range. So first I need to give the sheet name. Sheets. There is data sheet. In data sheet, it will go in range A 65,000. Then end Excel up. I'll use offset here because when it will go up, I need to put it down here. I need to move down one cell, one row. So I need to give here one for row, then zero. Dot value. Here I will paste value of item r as an integer. I define here integer div r as integer. So r's value will be here, but r will use some function. I want to use that max function, but it is not available in VBA. So whatever function I want to choose from my Excel, I need to give this keyword application dot worksheet function dot max, and using this then it demands for range. So I can give a column name. This range I give. So maximum will be transferred here. Okay. So data transfer. When I play this macro, there is nothing here. Actually, that's why the this function has not returned anything. So first, if I give here one, or I don't need to give here one. Okay, let us give one here. Then r equal to r plus one. After getting the maximum value, it will plus one and put the value here. So when I run the macro, what? Something problem with my max function. It should work like this. Max. Okay. I need to specify a range here. Then it will work right. Now it's working. When I again play macro, it is creating auto number. Yeah. Okay. Because this function is we are using in VBA, so VBA don't identify range as the only text. So we need to specify here range keyword. So if you don't put any value, then what happens? I play this macro and I will find one here because earlier it returned zero. Okay. So first query solved here. Then there will be date. So the same thing we will use, except this one. I will change it to 0 and here I will change it to 1. Why? Because when we are talking about 0, when we are going up here, then move down. here I have inserted 1. Now next entry I want to do here. So next time when it moves to here, if I use 1 there, so it will start from there. But I want to start right in this column. So that's why I have specified 0 here, and next column is 1. So in this value I need date. I will use date formula here. I can try here. So you can find date is coming here. Okay. Now the second thing I need, third thing I need, time. So for time I use now period. Okay, what's happening? On second column. Now see, we have some date and time also here. I don't need to use this. I will do date minus now. I will get the time. There is something. Date. No. From now minus date. Now, because it is a bigger value. Date. When I play this, I'll find some entries here. So a number format is also required here. This type of number format, this one, this format I want to use for number formatting. I use this format. How to apply number formatting? In the same value I use number format. Okay. Equal to in brackets I will give that number format. Which one? Which I copied from here. I am giving here number formatting. This thing I put it here. Okay. Now when I enter the any run macro, I'll find the time is here. The date time both is here. Now this date time query solved now. And now we have to simply transfer the name, roll number and marks. So what we will do, in the third column, I will give the reference of this form sheet. The cell is C2. So from sheets, that will be transferred with this equal. Okay, now let's see. I just play this macro from here. And fine. Here is the entry. Okay. So a similar entry will be here. C2, C4, C6, here I will use 4 and So I can see here marks 150, roll number is this one. When I play, I can find the whole data is inserted. So marks is here, roll number is here. Now there are entries. I want that after entry it should remove all the values from here. So what I need to do after this entry, I will do the without value will be this one. C2, C4 and C6. This code will be run. Okay. So when I run this macro, after inserting it will be removed. Okay. Now let us know how to work with buttons. So when you use this ActiveX control, this is an ActiveX control here. You have form controls and ActiveX control. If you want to run the macros, so you can use form control also and the shapes. So here when creating the button, it will ask which macro you want to attach. This macro was there. Okay. Now I enter here phone number, I just press it and I'll find the entry will be there. There is some error, it is not exceeding, the value is not maximizing. So what's the problem? Is taking the max range, but which range, which sheets, it is not specified. So I need to specify the sheet. That's why it is creating problem. Now it will work fine. Now test again. And again you will find, now it is working. Okay. What we are going to do that either we can attach macro through this form controls, or we can use ActiveX control. ActiveX control gives you flexibility to program within the video. When you double click it, there is a this procedure is created automatically. So we were programming in this module 1, and this available in command button 1. Now we want to use these macro in this VBA programming itself. So in form, what I will type to access that macro, I need to specify the name only here. When this button will be clicked, this macro will run automatically. Okay. With the help of only the name. Design mode of click, it is working. Okay. Another thing you want to do, if you don't like this button type of thing, you can create shapes also. So you can use shapes, because there are a lot of designs in shape. you can choose any of them to create fantastic buttons. Just right click on any shape and you will find assign macro. So assign any.
Yeah.
Okay. Now when you want to use this, you can use this one. Okay. So it is a simple data form, and in this method to behave like a form, you can use protection method also. Just click or select these fields, press Control 1 in protection, unlock this one and OK, then protect sheet and select unlock cell, uncheck this select unlock cell, then you can use when the you press it that it will shift in between of them. It will be like a form. Okay. By this
way,
in Excel you can create softwares. There is simple data transfer you can do with that.
Yeah.
Okay.
How to bring the entire sheet another workbook data, we want to bring it to the this particular sheet, this particular workbook. How to do that, sir?
Which one?
Suppose you have the data in another workbook.
Okay.
Okay. So I want to bring that data to this workbook in particular sheet.
You can do that. I will tell the workbook features after tomorrow.
Okay.
Or any other.
Yeah, sure. Okay, sure.
In which we will know how to save that, how to close that, how to delete that.
Okay, sir.
How to make new workbooks. Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. For today, I think it is sufficient. So
yeah.